हेलो एंड वेलकम एवरीबॉडी टू द क्रिएटरिक्स यूट्यूब चैनल एंड मायसेल्फ अंकित गोयल हेयर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू प्रेजेंटिंग अ लेक्चर ऑन एनालॉग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. सो गाइस सून यू विल बी वॉचिंग वन ऑफ द बेस्ट लेक्चर्स ऑन एनालॉग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. बट बिफोर डूइंग दैट लेट मी फर्स्ट इंट्रोड्यूस मायसेल्फ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स. माय नेम इज अंकित गोयल. आई गॉट AIR1 ट्वाइस इन गेट इन 2014 एंड 2018. आई वॉज अवॉर्डेड द प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया गोल्ड मेडल इन द ईयर 2013 व्हेन आई ग्रेजुएटेड फ्रॉम IIT इंदौर. Till date, I have taught more than 1 lakh students in the online and the offline classes, and presently I am working as a director at an academy for GATE department. But the reason, my friend, the reason for this series is because many students were asking for analog electronics, and I had recorded analog electronics just a short while ago. But due to that huge demand, we are giving you the recorded content of the analog electronics, and you are absolutely going to love it because it will provide you an in-depth analysis of analog electronics, and that analysis will be more based on network analysis than EDC. So if you don't have a prior knowledge of EDC, that is not at all required. When I'm teaching analog electronics, I'll be relating it more towards the network analysis. So you need to have a good basic understanding of network analysis so that you can do well in analog electronics. And my dear friend, what I believe is after this lecture series is over, your fear of analog electronics will definitely go away, and it will seem to be one of the easiest subject ever, because you will be applying the fundamental laws and you'll be finding all the answers. Okay, so it will become very, very easy even for an electrical engineer, because I believe electrical engineers think of analog electronics as a nightmare. They are more comfortable in machines, power system, but not in analog. But now this analog electronics course will stand you at par with the ECE engineers, and you will be able to do well in analog electronics, and I believe you can get 100% marks in analog in GATE and ESE through this course. Okay, so my dear friend, you need to watch all these videos carefully. You need to understand each and every point, and they will also have a large number of questions, so your problem solving ability will be developed. And now my dear friends, you can also join us on Unacademy Plus. With Unacademy Plus, what is the benefit if I'm teaching here on YouTube itself? My dear friend, GATE rank or ESE rank is not only about the lectures. First thing you have to understand that when you come to Unacademy, the level of teaching, the level of interaction, discussion is way higher than it can ever be done on YouTube, because there we are interacting live with the students, and you will feel that your teacher is sitting right in front of you and teaching you on a one-to-one basis. So that sort of a feeling you will get on Plus. You will feel like somebody is taking a tuition class when he is teaching on Plus. That level of personalization is there. But not only live classes, you also get recorded sessions. Whatever session you miss will be available in the recorded form. You get daily practice papers for practice. You get weekly tests to test your preparation level. You get test series, previous year question, question bank, short courses like crash course and rank improvement batch. And you also get doubt clearing by all the top educators. Now, when you get so many things in just one subscription, then I believe if you are serious enough to crack GATE and ESE, you can get the top rank in GATE and ESE. And you can also go for Iconic. Iconic is a superset of Plus subscription. It contains everything that is there in Plus, but many things that are there extra in Iconic, like a personal coach who will be guiding you on a one-to-one basis about the difficulties that you face, about your weaknesses, about the challenges that you might face, about the strategy part. Everything he will tell you in a one-to-one session. Then he will be seeing your test results and giving you a personalized test analysis about what are your weaknesses and how you can overcome them. Then every 2 weeks, there will be a study booster session in which you can ask your doubts, whatever problems you have, and they'll be helping you clear them. That is again one-to-one. Other than that, you will also get personalized study material. Here you will get theory notes and you will get question banks. You will get interview guidance. Soon enough, interview guidance will also be added. So the student who is starting his journey right now and looking to crack GATE and ESE with a top rank, Iconic will be the best subscription for that. Stay with me till the end of the video and I'll tell you about the pricing of these subscriptions. And my dear friends, if you like the videos that we are putting on YouTube, we have created an entire repository at this link. bit.ly/gatelive. Here you will find all the PDFs of all the lectures and all the YouTube links. So here you will find the complete syllabus of GATE, Electrical, EC and IN. You will find it arranged subject-wise, chapter-wise with lecture links and PDF. So this is better than any other paid course available in the market, and plus is even better than this. So you can understand. Whatever everybody else is providing you paid courses, we are providing you such a course for free via YouTube. So go and visit this link and take the benefit of all the lectures that are available. Other than that, my friend, I have also created a repository of my free classes on Unacademy called as the Special Classes. You need to open this URL, download the Unacademy Learning app, and you can attend all my free classes, live quizzes and test series. Yes, my dear friend, we are running a free test series as well. So once you download the Unacademy Learning app without even paying a single rupee, you can watch all the free classes by all the top educators along with their free live quizzes. And every Sunday we are conducting a free test that also you can become a part of. And if you want to learn from me, then my entire content is available on this URL. You can just go and visit this URL and see subject by subject, chapter by chapter, whatever I have taught, that will be available on this link. So first link will provide you all the YouTube classes for free and their PDF, and the second link will provide you my special classes on Unacademy. So that much content we are providing for free. Go and watch it, and if you like it, I would suggest that you come to Plus and use the code Ankit ESC. Because my dear friend, with Ankit ESC you will get an immediate 10% discount, as well as you will be connected to me and we can work together to get you the best GATE rank just like I obtained in 2014 and 2018. So if you want my guidance, if you want the best guidance in this market, if you want the best educators, then you have to join Unacademy. And while joining Unacademy, apply the code Ankit ESC to get immediate discount over and above whatever Unacademy is providing. You'll get 10% additional off. Okay. So now, my dear friends, let's go and watch the lecture and let's learn something new that you might never ever have learned. And let's enjoy the beauty of analog electronics. And I'll meet you again after the video and I'll tell you about the plans and the pricing.
Hi guys, in the previous video we have covered shunt negative clipper. So what I told you about shunt clipper? I told you that shunt clipper has diode connected in parallel to the load. And negative clipper means it clips voltage below a certain level. Then we saw that there were two cases in this: positive biased and negative biased. In positive bias, the reference voltage below which the voltage was clipped was positive. In negative bias, that voltage level was negative. In this lecture, what we'll do is we'll take a look at the shunt positive clipper, which will clip the voltage above a certain level. Earlier it was clipping below a certain level, now it will clip above a certain level, and it can also be positive biased or negative biased. So let us see. So this is the circuit of shunt positive clipper. If you compare it to the circuit that we covered in the last lecture, the diode polarity has been reversed. Now, what did I tell you about analyzing such circuit? That we can either apply open circuit test or short circuit test. Now, suppose I am applying open circuit test. First, I'll show using open circuit test. This is the resistance Vin. Then the diode will be open. This will be V naught. Now our purpose in open circuit test is to determine the voltage across the diode. Here the diode voltage is V naught. Since the circuit is open, it means that there is no current through the circuit. If there is no current through the circuit, the resistance voltage is zero, which means V naught is V in minus V R equal to V in. which means that the diode voltage is also equal to Vin. Is it fine? Now what happens? We'll say diode, only a single diode is there, diode is forward biased when diode voltage is positive. Diode voltage positive means Vin is greater than 0. In that case, if diode is forward biased, diode will be treated as short circuit. Now, if you treat the diode as short circuit, V0 will become 0. Then we will say that diode is reverse biased. Reverse bias means diode voltage negative. In that case, it will be open circuit. Diode voltage is equal to Vin. So, diode voltage negative means Vin negative. If Vin is negative and diode is open, if diode is open, we know that V0 will be equal to Vin. Here we have written this relation, V0 equal to Vin. The same thing we could have derived by applying short circuit test. In that case, when I apply short circuit test, what I'll do is, I will short circuit the diode. Like this. Now in short circuit test, our objective always is to find the current through the diode. The current through the diode is in this case Vin by R. Now we will say that the diode is on when the diode current is positive, which means Vin is positive. Now as you can see, if the diode is on, it is short circuited, which means V0 is 0. Then the diode will be off if diode current is negative, which means Vin is negative. If Vin is negative, diode is off, or you can say open circuit. In that case, V0 will be equal to Vin. So we are getting the same relation as in open circuit test with the short circuit test. So, if I summarize the result, I'll say when Vin is greater than 0, diode is on, V0 is 0. When Vin is less than 0, diode is off, V0 is equal to Vin. In such a case, if I draw the input and the output voltage waveform, first I will assume the input to be sinusoidal. Like this I will draw. Okay. Then when we talk about the output, this is our input. So I'll bring down these points of zero crossing. Then what is the output? When Vin is greater than 0, output is 0. When Vin is greater than 0, the output is 0. And when Vin is less than 0, this region, when Vin is less than 0, V0 is same as Vin, like this. Okay, so here V0 is Vin. So now if you see, it has clipped the positive cycle of the input waveform, that is why it is called as shunt positive clipper. It is clipping the positive cycle. At last, what we have to do in every clipper circuit, we have to draw the transfer characteristics. So what we will do is V0, Vin. So we are saying when Vin is positive, V0 is 0. When Vin is positive, V0 is 0. When Vin is negative, V0 equal to Vin. That means a straight line of slope equal to 1. So this will be the transfer characteristics of a shunt positive clipper. Now as we have done for the earlier videos, what I'll do is I'll connect a source which will serve as a reference voltage, and since this source is positive, it will be called as positive biased. Now I'll analyze this circuit using ओपन सर्किट टेस्ट. इन ओपन सर्किट टेस्ट व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल ओपन सर्किट दिस डायोड. ओके, now in open circuit test our objective is to find the diode voltage. When we have open circuited the diode, there is no current flowing in the circuit, I is zero. When I is zero, so what you can say, the voltage across the resistance voltage which is IR is also zero. This is VR. So what is V naught? By KVL, V naught is V in minus VR, which is equal to V in. So V naught is V in. Now if you want to find diode voltage, you will apply KVL, V naught minus VR, or you can say V in minus VR. Okay, so now what we'll say, diode is forward biased. Diode is forward biased when diode voltage is positive, or you can say V in minus VR is greater than 0. In such a case, V in is greater than VR, and if diode is forward biased, it will be replaced by short circuit. If diode is short circuit, then what you can say about V naught? V naught will be VR. Similarly, we'll say diode is reverse biased. When diode is reverse biased? When diode voltage is negative, or you can say it will behave as open circuit. Diode voltage will be negative when V in minus VR is negative, or you can say V in less than VR. In such a case, as we have seen, V naught will be equal to V in. Okay, so we have derived both the cases. When diode is on, V in is greater than VR. Diode is on, in that case V naught equal to VR. Then we said V in less than VR, diode is off, and V naught equal to V in. In both the cases, if I try to analyze this by drawing the input and the output voltage waveform, this is the input voltage, this is the output voltage. Okay, so now first I have to draw a wave similar to the input voltage waveform so that I can trace it later on, like this. Then what I will do is I will take a reference level VR. As I told earlier, maximum value of V in should be greater than VR, otherwise this condition will never be true. Now we are saying when V in is greater than VR, so we have to take intersections with VR. When V in is greater than VR, V naught is VR. That means in this region, when V in is greater than VR, V naught will be VR. V naught will be constant VR. Other than that, when it is less, V naught will follow V in. So I'll trace the curve, sinusoidal curve. It will follow V in. Okay. So if you see, it has clipped the voltage above a certain reference level. That is why it is called as positive biased shunt positive clipper. Now is the time to draw the transfer characteristic of this circuit. So what I will do is, this is V naught, this is V in. Now we see that the transition point in V in is at VR, output also at VR. When V in is greater than VR, V naught is VR. So above Vr, V naught is Vr. When Vin is below Vr, V naught is Vin, which means it is a straight line of slope equal to 1. Okay? So that is the characteristics of the positive biased shunt positive clipper. In the next circuit, what I will do is, I will reverse the polarity of this Vr and I'll try it by the second method, which is called as the short circuit test. In short circuit test, what I have told you? I have told you that our focus should always be on finding the current through the diode. Okay. So this is the current through the diode, R. Now in this case, if you see, by short circuiting the diode, the negative terminal gets connected to positive and positive gets connected to negative. V naught is minus Vr. Now diode current is equal to the resistance current. So diode current is Vin minus Vr over R. So diode current is Vin plus Vr over R. In short circuit test, we say diode is on when the diode current is positive. So Vin plus Vr is positive, or Vin is greater than minus Vr. Okay? Vin is greater than minus Vr. When diode is on, as I have written earlier, V naught will be equal to minus Vr. Now I will say diode is off. Diode is off when its current is negative, or the current tries to go from cathode to anode, which means Vin plus Vr is less than 0. If such thing happens, which means Vin is less than minus Vr, diode will be treated as open circuit. If diode is open circuited here, like this, if diode is open, what you can say is that there is no current, so the voltage drop across resistance is 0, which means V naught, the output voltage by KVL, will also be equal to V in. So we have derived both the condition when diode is on and when it is off. So if I summarize those condition, I'll say V in greater than minus Vr, diode is on, and V naught is minus Vr. V in less than minus Vr, diode is off, V naught is V in. Now, if I draw the input and the output voltage waveform, V in it will be like this. What about V naught? For drawing V naught, first I will trace the input voltage curve, because this curve will help me in drawing the output voltage. Now the threshold level is minus Vr, so I will draw a curve of minus Vr. Now the first case, or let us look at the second case, Vin less than minus Vr means this region. So let me take these points down. In this region, V naught is equal to Vin. If V naught is equal to Vin, so we will trace this input curve. Other than this region, V naught is minus Vr. So V naught is minus Vr. In between this, we will trace this curve. Okay. So now at last, if I want to draw the transfer characteristics, what I will do is I will take V naught on the y axis and V in on the x axis. Here the transition point is minus Vr, both on the x and the y axis. Now, when V in is greater than minus Vr, V naught is minus Vr, V in greater than minus Vr means on the right hand side it is minus Vr. Okay, like this. When V in is less than minus Vr, V naught is V in. So y is equal to x. So it is a graph of straight line with slope equal to 1. So these are the transfer characteristics of negative biased shunt positive clipper. So now once we have learnt all the different type of clipper, let us use these analysis to analyze a other more complicated circuit, that is a two level clipper. In two level clipper, there are two reference voltages V1 and V2. For this analysis, I am assuming that it is given that V1 greater than V2. Now for such type of circuit, what you have to do is you will apply open circuit test. Why not short circuit test? In this, if you apply short circuit test, then what will happen? Both diodes will be shorted. If both diodes are shorted, V1 and V2 will be in parallel, but two different voltage sources can never be in parallel. It violates KVL. That is why we will apply open circuit test. So when we are applying open circuit test, I will open circuit the diode. And as I have told in open circuit test, what we have to focus our attention on? We have to focus our attention on finding the voltage across the diode. Now if you see, when I have open circuited both the diodes, there is no path for the current flow. If there is no path for the current flow, the current is zero, which means the voltage across resistance, which is IR, is also zero. Now based on the diode polarity, this is the voltage across D1, this is the voltage across D2, V1, V2. First I will apply KVL. I'll write V0 is V in minus VR. V in minus VR will be how much? V in, because VR is 0. Now once I know V0, I'll write VD1. VD1 is V0 minus V1, or you can say V in minus V1. Similarly, I'll write VD2. VD2 is, VD2 will be how much? Let me write by KVL. I will not directly write. V2 minus VD2 is V0, which implies VD2 is V2 minus V0, V0 is Vin, V2 minus Vin. Now I say that a diode is forward biased if the voltage across diode is positive. So D1 is forward biased if D1 voltage is greater than 0. Vin minus V1 greater than 0, or you can say Vin greater than V1. Okay. If Vin is greater than V1, D1 is forward biased. If D1 is forward biased, it will be treated as short circuit. Now due to short circuit, you can see that V0 will become equal to V1. Okay, that is the case. Similarly, we can say that D2 is forward biased when voltage across D2 is greater than 0. Now see, in the previous case, voltage across D2 is V2 minus Vin. V2 minus Vin greater than 0 means Vin less than V2. Now when this D2 is forward biased, it will be short circuited. If it is short circuited, V0 will be equal to V2. So now what conditions do I have achieved? If Vin is greater than V1, D1 is on, V0 equal to V1. V in less than V2, D2 is on V0 equal to V2. But now we know V1 is greater than V2. See, suppose V1 is 5, so I am saying Vin greater than 5. Suppose I am saying V1 is 5, V2 is 3. So this condition says Vin greater than 5. The second condition says Vin less than 3. Okay, one is greater than 5, other is less than 3. The in between condition will be when Vin lies between V2 and V1. If Vin lies between V2 and V1, both D1 and D2 are off. If both D1 and D2 are off, V0 will be equal to Vin. Okay, in this case, V0 will be equal to Vin. Now let me show you this in terms of input and the output voltage. Okay, I'll take just one cycle. I'll bring it down to trace the input voltage also. Okay, now there are two levels in which V1 is greater than V2. Suppose this is V2. Now, when input voltage is greater than V1 in this region and input voltage less than V2 means this entire region. Okay, it is less than V2. When it is greater than V1, the voltage becomes V1. The voltage becomes V1 like this. When it is less than V2, the voltage becomes V2. So I'll bring down these intersections also. When it is less than V2, the voltage becomes V2 like this. In between, none of the diodes are on, the voltage follows Vin like this. Okay, so now if you see the lower part and the upper part, both parts of the waveform are clipped. That is why it is called as a two level clipper. If you want to draw the characteristics of this circuit, transfer characteristics, then there are two transition, one at V2, other at V1. I have told you that V2 is less than V1. Now, when input is greater than V1, input is greater than V1, output is V1. When input is less than V2, output is V2. In between, output is Vin, so this is a straight line of slope equal to 1. Okay, and that was the main reason why I took that V1 is greater than V2. Otherwise, these two conditions cannot be simultaneously true. In this circuit, it should always be given that V1 is greater than V2. Otherwise, this circuit cannot be solved. Otherwise, the condition, what it would have become? First condition, Vin greater than V1. Other is Vin greater than less than V2. Now, this is Vin greater than 3, Vin less than 5. I am saying if V2 is 5, V1 is 3. Or I am saying V1 less than V2. Now, greater than 3, D1 is on. Less than 5, D2 is on. What happens for 4? Think about 4 volt. 4 volt is greater than 3, D1 will be on. 4 volt is less than 5, D2 will be on. But both diodes cannot be on, otherwise KVL will be violated. That is why in the beginning itself I took V1 is greater than V2, otherwise KVL would have been violated. So let me summarize what we have covered. In this lecture I have told you about shunt positive clipper. In shunt positive clipper, we saw clips above a reference level. Then we saw it has two categories, positive biased and negative biased. This is when reference voltage is positive, reference voltage is negative. Then I told you about two level clipper in which we clip both waveform above and below a certain value. Here we have two levels V1 and V2. In between V0 was equal to Vin, and above and below these levels the voltage was clipped. So again you have to remember the basic method, that is solution by open circuit or short circuit test. In two level clipper, open circuit test is more beneficial. Okay, so if you go by these tests, then your solution would be very much easy as compared to directly remembering how does a circuit work. Always try and analyze in terms of open circuit and the short circuit test. Thank you.
Hello everybody, how did you like the lecture? Did you like it or not? Did you enjoy the concepts or not? Tell me in the chat and the comment section. Did you guys like what you just saw? Did you guys understand each and everything, my dear friends? Okay, so if you liked it, then please share, please like the video, and please leave a comment behind, because your comments are very, very valuable to all of us, and we do read your each and every comment and we go through them to understand what are the difficulties you are facing and how we are performing on YouTube. And my dear friend, a bonanza for you. Every subject is available on this YouTube channel. You just need to scroll through the channel and you will find all the courses. EDC, EMT, COM, Machine, Power System, Power Electronics, Network, Signal, Control, Digital, Maths, Apti. Everything is available here. Everything. So you can just use this channel as your entire preparatory study material. Okay. Other than that, now all of you who wanted to know about the pricing of Plus, 1 year subscription on Plus will cost you 27 to 25 if you apply the code Ankit ESE. But now, my dear friend, there is a new subscription, 18-month subscription. Those of you who are starting your preparation mid-year can target GATE twice, or you can target GATE and ESE mains with 1.5 year subscription. That will cost you 34,650 if you apply the code Ankit ESE. If you see the difference, only 7,000 difference is there, but you are getting 6 months extra. And even better, you can go for 2 year. It will cost you 39,600. That is again, in just 5,000 rupees, you are getting 6 months extra. So you can target all the exams like GATE, ESE, semester exams, ISRO, BARC, everything you can target with just one subscription. And if you go for Iconic, in which I told you about the personal coach, study material, interview guidance, for 12 months it will cost 4,500 if you use the code Ankit ESE, and for 24 months it will cost you 54,000 if you use the code Ankit ESE. Ankit ESE is your code, my code, our code, and that will give you an instant 10% discount over and above whatever Unacademy is offering you. And my dear friend, that will connect you to me so that we can work together towards getting the best GATE rank. So don't hesitate, join today, because winners always start early, winners never start late. So it's always better to start immediately rather than thinking about it and becoming late and later on regretting your decision. Believe me, you will not even regret one day when you join Plus. So it's high time that you join Unacademy Plus and get the best out of you and become the best version of yourself. And my dear friend, this is the Telegram channel for our YouTube team. You will find all the lecture updates here. And this is my personal Telegram channel. If you wish to get in touch with me with my personal Telegram channel, GATE AIR1. Okay, GATE AIR1 is my Telegram channel. You can get connected to me. You will get notes, you will get lecture links, everything you will get here. All the new initiatives information will be provided here. These are the other channels that we are running in other than Creatrix. You will find Electrical Junction. Here you will find short videos for GATE preparation, GATE question for PYQ, GS terminal for non-technical content of SSC and RRB, Paathshala to learn engineering through animation, SSC JE for your JE and AE exams, my dear friends. Other than that, Telugu, if you want to learn engineering, or GATE and EAC preparation in the Telugu language. If you are comfortable with it, go for Telugu. Other than that, we have separate channel for mechanical, civil, computer science. You will find all these channels. Please share these channels with your friends as well, so that they can also get benefited in the same manner that you are getting benefit from our side. Okay, so thank you everybody. See you soon in the next video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Share it among your college friends, among your Facebook, WhatsApp, Telegram, Instagram, everywhere you need to share it. And you need to subscribe to this channel, press that red button and hit the bell icon, because my dear friend, this channel is creating a revolution in the GATE and EAC industry, and you, my friend, are a part of this revolution. So see you soon. Thank you.